Hi guys, I'm back again. So today I am going to show you guys how I actually create this makeup look. It is my go-to almost every day when I, you know, was in college. I just graduated like a few days ago. So my whole time here, I don't have like, you know, full face of makeup on. That being said, I don't have like, you know, I actually never wear my eyeshadow look outside of my house. I just have like my full face. I really like focusing on my face. It just burp. I'm so gross. Sorry. I like focusing on my face pretty much, and you know, just making sure the complexion is like, you know, really good and smooth. And I do like dewy finish looking foundations and look. And I do wear glasses most of my time all the time, because I hate contact lenses. I used to have like a really bad history with contact lenses, so that's why. I create this very dewy looking look using one of my, you know, using my favorite products for daytime. And it is definitely not full coverage, but it does look good on like if you want to go out or like whatever. And this might be too much for everyone, but this is what I do. I wear makeup all the time. I have shit ton of makeup, and I do want to make use out of, you know, use every. I do want to use everything that I could for everything else. That being said, if you guys are interested, come check this out. Continue watching. I'll show you guys, you know, how to actually create this look. And if you guys want to know more about me, want to watch me grow on YouTube or like, you know, soon hopefully, follow me and like this video and check me out on my other social links. And thank you so much again for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video hopefully soon. Thank you. I'm going to start. What I'm going to do today, I'm going to use this one. I usually use the Ordinary primers because I don't use my high-end primers all the time, because I like to save them up for like, you know, more, I guess, for some events when I feel like really being bougie or something, so I usually use drugstore primers. I'm going to show you guys my everyday, like not everyday, but personal makeup. I do have a lot of makeup, but I do freelance sometimes for my, you know, friends and, you know, some girls around my college. But this is what I usually use. These are the things that I use all the time. And I only use this for myself. I never, like, these are like my babies pretty much. I don't share them with like everyone else. And I'll show you my day, and then I'll show you guys next time when I feel like doing like full glam. And if you guys have any other like questions about like what I use and everything, so let me get started. What I'm going to use today is because when I have my SPF on, especially with my Drop Telephone SPF, I cannot put so much silicone primers on my face because it does pile up, which is very crazy and annoying. But I do really love that SPF because it is zinc oxide, and I do not like how do I say this? And I don't like chemical sunscreen. I like that physical sunscreen on my face. That's what I use. For primer, I don't really like to put anything on my face using my hands because I find them dirty, or sometimes I'm lazy to wash my hands. So I'm gonna start by putting my high spreadability foot primer. And I'm going to use my mirror here, and what I do is really just wrap this. It has like oh shit, see how it drips everywhere? I don't like this thing, just specifically this primer, to be honest. I'm more of a person if I don't feel like I have time to get ready, I'm not gonna wear any makeup at all. I just wear like shit ton of sunscreen and that's all. Because I'm more of like kind of like all or nothing kind of person. I don't really care. I try to think that I do makeup for myself, not for like everyone else. I still feel good if I don't have any makeup on to go out or like whatever. But I do find it very, I like myself to look very, how do I say this? I think it's very proper for you to like get ready to go to like events, and like I think it's a way to like respect people somehow. I really want to look like I made an effort to like, you know, go somewhere and I'm just like, oh, I just woke up and I'm just gonna like, you know, go to this event or like whatnot. So what I'm gonna do, I just put all my my primers. This thing, it really helps with like, it doesn't feel very silicone-y as compared to the Kylie Urine Silicone Primer or my smoothing primer serum from Paula's Choice. This is fucking amazing, guys, but it's a little expensive. It does have SPF, but it is a chemical sunscreen. I tried it, but I'm not sure yet. I've only tried it a couple times. I need to play around with this more because I'm pretty sure chemical sunscreen breaks me out like the whole damn time, which I hate. So what I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna use the High Spareability Free Primer. I already did this. Okay. For my everyday look, I'm trying to like finish this thing. I've had this for like a long time, probably more than 2 years, and it doesn't break me out. Still, I don't know why. I'm trying to like finish this because this is one of my first foundations that I've ever gotten, and I kind of felt like mad about it. But at the same time, it does give you like a really good finish, but it doesn't last as long. But I tried this combination because I really, really love this Ordinary Serum Foundation. It is a dupe for like Infallible Pro Glow, but this has like a... I'm an ingredient kind of freak. I don't like to put like shitty stuff on my face. I mean, it's kind of ironic because I put makeup all the time, but at the same time, I like to be like more informative. I like to know what I'm putting on my face. This one is pretty drying, although it is actually pro. It's a glowing foundation, but this one, I like this one more. And it's actually cheaper than this thing too. It's like $6, and I really like it. It feels like nothing on your face. It is not full coverage though, but I don't need much coverage to be honest. I don't have like bad acne, I just have like little scarring, but I'm pretty happy with my skin right now. So what I'm gonna do, I don't mix my foundation. I don't know why I should, I'm not that kind of girl. I usually layer my foundation. I would just use this, either this one first or this one first. This has like a similar consistency. This is pretty watery. This one is like less watery, but like it is still a pretty watery foundation. So what I would do is like go with the thicker, more moussey foundation first, and then go with like a, I'm not sure if it's like supposed to be that way, but like that's what I usually do. But this one, I usually put anything on the back of my hand because again, I hate putting anything on my face straight away. And I'm just gonna put like a pump of this one. And then, I'm gonna use my Sigma Flat Kabuki F80 brush. I really like this brush, but my all-time favorite brush is definitely the F buffing brush. Spreads pretty finely. I really like it. But this one, I got it on a whim when they had like a sale last time. It was like 2 years ago, I think. And I would use the off-bending brush, but it's kind of like gross. So I'm gonna use this instead. So yeah. I'm sorry if I sound very weird, but sorry. I don't know what's wrong. I don't know what's wrong with me, to be honest. But at the same time, I want to film something. I just feel like I owe you guys a video. I mean, I don't think like anyone really cares about my video that much. It's not like I have like shit ton of followers or anything. But I do really appreciate people who actually take the time and watch my videos. I like to talk. And I prefer longer videos. Okay, my camera cut off just now, but whatever. What I was saying is that I prefer 10 like longer videos because I don't know, I just feel like I would find more information, or I'm just like that nosy to know what people do, and that's what I usually do. This one is pretty watery. If you want to wear this alone, you could use a stippling brush instead of like buffing brush too, but with stippling brush, I find it very annoying because I would have to end up using Beauty Blender anyway, because it does leave streaky lines, but I don't know why, there's something about stippling brushes that are like pretty fun. I don't know. This is like not like full glam, but it gives you like such beautiful finish. And you really can, like, not, I don't know. I have pretty, like, normal skin, but it just gets pretty dry in the winter, and it's, like, fucking cold outside. But, you know, I could stop here, because I am pretty happy. I'm pretty damn happy with my face right now. But because I'm filming, and I'm feeling, like, extra, but not, like, too extra, I'm going to add another pump of this one. And I feel like I can be generous with this thing, or, like, with, like, you know, my Giorgio Armani. Giorgio Armani is, like, wait, I think it's at least 9 times, like, more expensive than this foundation. Which is fucking crazy. I don't know why, what I actually even bought this foundation. Okay, I started doing makeup, like, 2 years ago. And I saw people, like, really, you know, everybody, like, doing all this, what is it called again? Using this Luminous Silk foundation. And the funny thing is, like, I got this in the winter. Like, it was almost towards the end of the winter. And I got, like, shade match by, mind you, like, at this point of time, I was just, like, a regular consumer. Like, I'm still really a regular consumer at the time. I was not really, like, informed consumer to, you know, to know, like, is it good or not, like, how do I find my shade and everything. And this thing is, like, this thing is pretty pink for my liking, to be honest, now that I've, like, discovered, like, what I like, what I look good at. And, you know, I'm gonna do concealer. This is my favorite concealer for daytime, because it is, like, it gives you such beautiful finish. And I'm going to color correct with my, what is this thing? With my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade Honey. Okay, when I first got this, hold on a second. When I first got this, I thought it was actually my concealer shade. It was so stupid. I don't know why that lady, I mean, don't get me wrong, she's really nice, but at the time I was just like, okay, this is good, blah blah blah, I think this is your good shade. And I have, like, a really pretty yellow undertone. It's so stupid, because she gave me, like, a color correcting shade, which is so weird. Oh my god, it's so funny. So I'm gonna put this, like, literally here, when I have, like, a dark circles or whatever. This is pretty old. This thing is, like, at least 2 years old. Oh, that's fine. I'm not gonna, like, throw this out, just because this shit is expensive. I feel bougie whenever, like, I wear this. It's kind of funny. But you can see, it's very, like, how do I say this? It is pretty, pink and peachy, which is great. At least I have, like, something to make use of. You know what I mean? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my, okay, don't judge me. I don't have, like, any clean beauty blender. I have a lot of, like, beauty blender, but, like, I need to clean all this. What the fuck? Okay, that's fine. oh my god. And I can't believe it. But this one is decent. Guys, I'm so gross. I'm sorry. I'm just too lazy to clean it up. But whatever. And I'm too lazy to, like, wet this anyway. What am I See, I'm, like, the laziest fucking person ever. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna use this and, just pat this on my face. Oh my god, I just realized this is better. Okay, pat this on my face. Okay, my friend, she was supposed to come here and help me film or whatever, but she said she's lazy. And I totally get it. It's, like, super cold and it was snowing yesterday, and he lives, like, 10 blocks away, I think. And which is pretty far for, like, someone who walks all the time. So, that's fine. I'm not, like, gonna... I love her. What I'm gonna do is just, like, layer this concealer. This one is more for, like, brightening and stuff. I don't like to go far out, because I like to make my face slimmer. Because I have, like, pretty round face. So what I'm gonna do, I'm being pretty generous with this concealer, because I really genuinely love this concealer. I've probably, like, used this concealer. I've probably run out of the concealer at least 3 times, and I have, like, a backup, which is so funny. I have this, like, in all shades, I think. Like, I know, like, 115, 120 is for me, and, like, darker tones for my, like, if I do, like, my clients' makeup, if they're like, you know, African American or something, it looks good on everybody, and I could use that to contour my face too. But I like the LA Girl Pro Concealer to contour more. But what I'm gonna do, just do this thing, just pat my concealer with my sponge. This I got from L'Oreal. It looks actually pretty decent, but you know what? I have tried so much Beauty Blender, like sponges, and I swear, the best is still the Beauty Blender original sponge. Because you know why? It's like, it's very porous, but this one is like, it's not as porous, but it's still spongy. But like, I'm going to set my face with Laura Mercier. I cannot live without this powder, I don't know why. Okay, I like the Coty Airspun, but it smells like shit. And I like the RCMA, but I find it very... I don't like white powders, to be honest. I use that to set like my whole damn face, but not like to bake my eye, per se. I find that I rarely ever use RCMA. It's pretty cheap, but like... That oregano jar is like stupid. What the fuck? And this one, if I ran out of this thing, I would probably like replace it with like RCMA powder, like whatever. I've had this for like at least 2 years, and like I still have like a lot of it because I only specifically use this to bake my under eye. What I usually do is I use mineralized skin finish. This is like my holy grail. If I were to be rich at some point, I would have this in every damn color, I swear. Because you know what? It's like the best powder. The best powder ever. It gives you like such a nice finish. It gives you like, it's weird. And I have like shit ton of powders, it's kind of weird. I have the Studio Fix powder foundation. That one is like pretty matte, and I don't really like it. I don't know why. But I'm gonna use it with the Wet n Wild powder brush, and I'm just gonna swirl it and just pat. Like, bronzy situation, but I usually use this one, this Chanel Solid and the Chanel bronzer. This is really really cool. This is really really nice as it for a bronzer, because okay, one, it's a Chanel, and I'm such a brand kind of like person. If there's one brand of makeup that I could use my whole damn life, it would be, I have no idea. Let's see. Probably not Chanel. Probably when I'm like 6 years old, I will wear Chanel. But... interesting. I don't know. Probably... to brighten my under eye. So I'm gonna use the NYX finishing powder in the color Banana. This one is pretty light for my liking, but this one is amazing. Oh god. I really, really like it. And I could just like use it on my forehead. I don't have any forehead. I don't have for my forehead. Like, my forehead's like non-existent. But I swear, right now, if you guys could see my face right now, it's fucking flawless. I'm not even exaggerating. It's beautiful. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna put some blush. Okay, I'm weird. I like to put blush on my face, even though I am a guy. But I use this Pearlescent Pink by Wet n Wild. This is like the exact dupe for like NARS Orgasm. I don't have money for that, so I'm just gonna use Wet n Wild. I use the Real Tonic Blush Brush. Oh, this one, I really go like, I just wanna some like hints of like color on my face. So, yes. Just like that. Okay. Then we're done. Like, that's all. I don't like contour or like whatever, and I did my brows and put on some mascara, and I'm gonna put some dust in just before we go ahead and do anything else. I don't usually put mascara on my lower lash line because I feel like I find it too much for like the daytime. Vice pencil waterproof thing. in the shade nude under my on my waterline because I want to look like I'm not dead. Oh shit, the fuck? Kidding. This thing is crazy. So I'm gonna get another one. This one is really good too. This is the NYX Wonder Pencil in the shade Light, I think. This is better. It's not as smooth, but it really is very subtle. Kau ini berapa bulan? Berapa hari bulan? Hello.
Okay.
Kau ini yang pukul berapa bulan? Hello.
Tengah.
Kau ini yang pukul berapa bulan? Hello.
16 lah.
Kau macam bila nak masuk? Okay, but that's how I usually do it. And what am I gonna do now? Okay, I'm going to thanks. Clean my lips. And you got a lot. Apa lah awak jadi gini?
Apa
okay, so what I'm gonna do right now, I am going to put some fix stuff on. I have my fan ready, because I usually have it like that. Okay. And I'm gonna just be very generous. And I don't like to put setting spray on because I don't know why I'm so weird like that. If I feel extra, I use the mattifying setting spray by CoverFX. This one is just like all nighter by Urban Decay, but this one doesn't have any alcohol, so I like it a lot. Oh my god, my roommate is so annoying. He's like next to me, he's like sending messages. Rude. So I don't really like to clean up my contour or like whatnot if I go out like during the day. What I really like to do. Eddie, could you do me a favor? Kak, nama putih tu boleh tak? My back got opal. And it's like my skin tone, so like I layer it with like, this is my base for highlight because I'm weird like that. I use my trusty Real Technique contour brush just to like pat this on my cheeks. You could stop here. But what I usually do, just do this. I really like to highlight under my, over my, see, I can't speak, forehead, because I don't have any forehead, so fucking small. So I'm gonna use this. I only use opal to like, highlight my nose. Do that. My cupid's bow. Okay. There's that. And most of the time I layer it with like, say, Master Chrome or like whatever. This shit is amazing. Amazing. I'm just trying to like blow my roommate. Just because. You could, you don't have to go ham with this, but this thing is, oh god. Beautiful. I don't really feel bad for like layering highlight. I don't get why people hate so much like the glowing thing. Like, I like it. Stop being so mean. Like my roommate. Rude. Oh my god. My roommate is crazy. So, what I'm gonna use is my MAC lipstick in the shade Yash. And this is really what I do. Turn on my, let me see if I could Okay, perfect. I had to turn on my lights, artificial lights, because it is getting darker outside, and this might look, it's pretty glowy, it's pretty, I don't know what's wrong with my lights, what the fuck? You see a difference? Okay, I think it's better. What is wrong with this thing? Can I put it in a good color? What's it? That is better. Just zoom this in to show you guys. I look so cute. And this is the final look. What do you guys think? No filter whatsoever. I think it's pretty darn good. Look at this foundation though. Okay, this fucking lighting is crazy. Okay, cute. Okay.